Well, guys out there and bearded ladies, do you need to shave your beard because of COVID-19? And by the time you're watching this video, I'll be back in the hospital. And do I need to shave my beard now that I'm going back to work? There's the CDC guidelines that came out in 2017 about N95 respirator masks and having a good seal around the nose and around the mouth, and therefore you can't have a beard. What's that all about? Well, check this out. All right, first things first, do you need to shave a beard? The answer is no, unless you're wearing a N95 respirator mask as if you're a healthcare worker. The reason why the answer is no is because there aren't any studies to indicate whether having a clean shaven face makes you either more or less prone to getting COVID-19 and or spreading COVID-19. So there's no evidence either way, and anyone who claims to know that answer doesn't know what they're talking about when it comes to that. Now, when I was seeing COVID-19 patients in the hospital who were suspected of having it, what I would do is I would wear a PAPR, a powered air purified respirator. And this is essentially like those space suits that you see where there's a clear shield in front and then they have the, it's like a helmet looking thing. And then there's a hose that attaches in the back and that purifies the air. Now that serves the purpose of things that are airborne transmitted. So right now with COVID-19, it looks like there is some transmission that occurs through airborne. And the way that occurs, well, there's a study that showed that the virus lingers in the air for up to 3 hours. So the way that's going to be transmitted is when someone's in, usually inside, such as an elevator, and someone coughs or sneezes, and then that becomes aerosolized, and then the virus starts to slowly fall down. That's actually the least common way that the virus is transmitted. The most common way is through contact and also through respiratory droplets. Now, respiratory droplets, that can occur when anyone is simply just breathing or just talking, but also occurs when someone's coughing and sneezing. And the way that works is whenever we're talking or coughing or sneezing, that droplet comes out of the mouth and it's about 6 feet, it goes about 6 feet before it hits the ground. And if the wind is blowing, that can carry that droplet anywhere. I remember when I was talking to someone, someone new that I met at work, and very friendly, and we're just talking, and you know, we're maintaining distance. It was like 5-6 feet, something like that. I didn't actually measure it, but anyway, I just remember, you know, she's talking to me, and I'm looking at her, and I remember seeing this droplet coming not straight towards my face, but it just dodged me, like went like that. And I just, all I could think about was COVID in the air, just like that. So anyway, respiratory droplets is the main way, that in contact is the main way of transmission. That's why surgical masks, not the N95 masks, they prevent the spread of the disease, because when someone has the virus in them and they go to talk or cough or sneeze, that mask prevents that droplet with the virus from being put in the air and getting onto surfaces, getting onto other people, and so forth. Do people need to shave their beard to reduce their chance of getting infected and to reduce their chance of spreading infection? No, the beard can stay as long as you're not a healthcare worker needing an N95. So with me going back to the hospital tomorrow, I have to shave this bad boy right here, and not really looking forward to it, but it's what I gotta do. And based on the CDC's recommendation, in order for me to get a tight fit with the N95. So that's the thing too, is with these N95 masks, normally I just wear a PAPR, but because PAPRs are in limited supply and you gotta clean them every time and disinfect them, you know, it's not practical for all the healthcare workers to be able to use the PAPRs. That's why we have to switch to N95s to reduce the airborne transmission of the virus. And not only that, so the PPE that's in short supply, so we have to make the most out of these N95 masks. Therefore, we get one per day, and we'll switch it out every day, and they'll be disinfected. So that's the process. That's why I have to shave my beard, and that's why I have to do it right now, today. So I guess what I can do is take a look at the CDC guidelines. They have recommendations on beards and what's acceptable and what's not acceptable. So let's take a look. So this is the website here. This is what it looks like. Let's look at what is approved for the N95 and what is not approved. All right, so what's not approved? You can't have any stubble. No stubble, no short stubble, no long stubble, no full beard, no French fork, whatever that is. No ducktail. No Verdi, it's like looks like Italian, sounds Italian. Garibaldi, no Garibaldi, no bandoles. The chin curtain's a no-go, the extended goatee, like Robert Downey Jr. in Iron Man, hell yeah. See, circle beard, that's a no-go. It says anchor and balbo, whatever that is. It says, careful, chin hair may easily cross the seal line. The Van Dyke, no, that's pretty cool, but that's a no-go. Same with Imperial. Huh. The mutton chops and the hoolihe. If I had to choose one, I'd probably go with the hoolihe. Look at those chops. The horseshoe. I don't know if I could do that one. The Zappa, that's pretty cool. The walrus, this ain't thick enough for the walrus. Plus, I feel like you gotta have a body shaped like a walrus in order to pull that off. The painter's brush, okay, that's approved. Chevron, nah. Handlebar, it's kind of cool. You can do that, that's an option. The pencil, ooh, there's two variations of the pencil. One's a little curved and one's a little... The toothbrush, I think that's more like the Hitler. The lampshade. Zorro, hey, come on, Zorro. The villain, careful not to cross the seal. That's the Raleigh Fingers for you right there. The Fu Manchu. I wish I could have a Fu Manchu. Do you know how awesome that would look? Going like this. The English, that's pretty crazy. All the way out to here, that stash. The Dolly. Yep, so some of these are approved, some of these are not. Let's see, let's try some of these out, shall we? Good morning, sunshine.
Yeah, I reckon they come by around here. That good? That's good. Yeah.
But they should rename this the Lemmy from Motorhead.
The Ace of Spades! The Ace of Spades!
Now you have to realize there are a lot of people out there, unfortunately, that exist in our society that are pedophiles, but they don't just walk around with pedophile stamped on their forehead. But if they have a stash like this, that's probably the closest thing. The toothbrush.
It's gone. It's gone. It's all gone.
All right, so how we're doing it for pulmonary and critical care is we get one N95 mask per day. We use it the whole day. This is my A mask. At the end of the day, I'll put my A mask in a bag and it gets sent off to the UV machine for disinfecting. And then tomorrow, I'll wear the B mask. I wear that all day. And then at the end of tomorrow, I'll have that one sent off for cleaning. And yeah, that's actually the reason why I had to shave my beard so that I could wear these N95 masks, because the PAPRs are limited. So the way that we're doing it now forced me to shave my beard, which I didn't even recognize myself in the morning, but oh well. And then when we go to see COVID-19 patients in the hospital, or those suspected of having COVID-19. I wear a gown, of course, and I put these stylish AF goggles over my glasses. And I double glove as well. When I'm done seeing, and there's a stethoscope already in the room, so I'm not using this stethoscope here. But after, you know, I'm done seeing the patient, I clean these, I disinfect these goggles, and I take off the surgical mask that I wear on top of this N95 mask and deglove, and that's how the process works. So that's where we're at.